Hi, I'm Marge Easley with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to talk with us so you can learn more about them. Joining us now is Todd Hughley, candidate for Circuit Court Judge, Position 15, District 20. That's a mouthful.
Yes, it is.
Hi, Todd. Nice to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. Tell us about yourself, your career, and how you ended up running for Circuit Court Judge.
So a little bit about my background. My grandparents moved to Washington County in the 1940s and early 1940s, and I spent most of my life here, grew up here, went to college down in Eugene, and I began my career as a software engineer. So I had a career prior to law, and it came as no surprise to the people that know me that I decided to change careers where I could start work with people, more directly with people, because that's what really drives me is helping people. So I went to law school down at Willamette, and I earned my joint degree, JD, and my MBA. And then I immediately was drawn to constitutional law and trial work. So during law school, I volunteered at Metropolitan Public Defenders and then joined as a certified law student defending criminal cases. And then soon after I graduated, I joined MPD in Hillsborough as a staff attorney, where I represented indigent clients in criminal cases, child support cases, spousal support cases, civil commitments, mental health, addiction.
Lot.
Yes, quite a bit. So extensive trial court experience with the public defender's office. And then I left the public defender's office and started my own firm practicing civil law all throughout the state. Representing injured Oregonians.
Got it. And this is an interesting position that has opened up. Can you tell us a little bit about the circuit court system and why this position is special?
So most people don't have the opportunity to appear in court, which is a good thing, because if you're in court, it's because you have a difficult issue that you can't resolve with another party. So the circuit court is the first level court that you would probably go to. Could be landlord-tenant issues, could be traffic issues, civil issues, personal injury, family law, juvenile law, and then what most people think of, criminal. So the circuit court level, is that's where all those issues are decided and the facts are laid out. And this position's unique because Washington County is growing rapidly and the court system hasn't quite kept up. We've needed additional judges in Washington County for some time. We've been lobbying for them. And recently the legislature we asked for two and they gave us one additional position. So this is a brand new position that we're filling right now, and it's needed really bad.
Is that because of the population growth in Washington County?
Or? Yes, I believe it's the first new position we've added in 16 to 20 years.
Wow, very good. Do you feel that the resources allocated to the court system is adequate? I know that there was a little bit of additional money allocated to allow the slot to open up, but as far as the courts in general, what's your opinion?
I don't think that the funding is sufficient. It's probably not sufficient for any of the jurisdictions around the state. The state itself just has funding issues, funding education and the court system. But specifically with the court system, I think that we need more funding so we can offer alternative programs for people that come into the court system, specifically mental health and addiction treatment. With additional funding, we could expand those courts that we have within the Washington County Court to better serve our population.
So that brings me to this alternative sentencing idea, and these I am particularly interested in the addiction courts and the diversion from prison. So could you tell us a little bit about your philosophy on that?
So I'm a big supporter of alternative courts and alternative sentencing. My time at the public defender's office taught me that many people that enter the criminal system are entering it due to lots of times issues they had growing up. They grew up in a drug addicted household. Their parents suffered from mental illness. They suffer from mental illness. So really what's driving that criminal behavior is the mental illness or the addiction. And if we can expand on the mental health court mm-hmm. and the drug court, and then also attached community programs, outpatient mental health care, and inpatient and outpatient drug treatment, I think expansion of those two programs would help our community immensely.
Great. I was just reading that our opioid addiction issues are getting better in Oregon, which was great news. Mm-hmm. So hopefully there'll be a little less work for you, but it's always a challenge. I ask this of most judicial candidates because in some places judges are appointed rather than elected. In Oregon, we do have a little of each. Is that true?
That's correct. We have a hybrid system.
And so what do you think, our system is a good one, or would you see some improvement in the way judges are chosen?
I do like the hybrid system that we have. I think that generally judges in Oregon are appointed because when a judge retires midterm, the governor fills that slot, and then that person runs in the next election. Most judges don't run in contested races, so once you're appointed, your subsequent races are uncontested. But I do think that having elected judges is a good thing because it gives the people a vote and a voice in the third branch of government, which is our judicial branch, and most people don't really think about that. But when they see a contested election on the ballot, it might kind of get them thinking.
That's what we like to see, that those of us in the league, because we also feel it gives voters a chance to get to know you. And what are your thoughts on community relationships and building that as a judge? Is that a difficult thing to do?
I don't think it's difficult. I think for me personally, that's one of the driving forces. One of the things that I plan to do if I'm elected is engage with the community more. Already I've been going out and speaking with the community, telling them about my campaign, that I'm running for judge, and they're just blown away that I'm making that outreach. They've never met a judge. They don't really know anything about the court system, the court process, and they're really excited to talk to me.
Great, that's good to hear. So what would you say, I know that as you learn more about what a judge, all the responsibilities and the challenges, what are the things that you're looking forward to, and what are the things that may be challenges?
Well, I'm most looking forward to being able to help people in our community. As a lawyer, I help my clients and I get to advocate for my clients. But as a judge, you get to interact with both parties and the people in the courtroom every day, and there's many, many people that come through, and you get to make an impact on their lives. And so I'm looking most forward to that. The challenging part is, with the exception of weddings, virtually nobody wants to be in court. Neither party wants to be there. They've got a dispute that they can't resolve, and you're making a decision that is going to affect both parties and generally make one party unhappy.
Gotcha.
And so those are difficult decisions, and that's why we have a judge, and it's a really important position.
Absolutely. So in about 1 minute, can you tell voters why people should vote for you as opposed to your opponent?
So a circuit court judge, a trial judge mm-hmm. in Washington County, handles a wide variety of cases, and I think my background and experience in law is unique and different than my opponents. I have a broad range of legal experience handling domestic relations cases, mental health cases, addiction cases, civil cases, criminal cases, a significant number of jury trials. I believe that I've handled over 1,600 filed cases around mm-hmm. the state, 1,500 in Washington County alone, appeared in thousands of hearings, and ultimately a circuit court judge is a trial judge, and you need to have that in-court experience so you can make the decisions and know the temperament, the decisiveness, and the patience that it takes to be a judge.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for being here. It was great talking with you.
Thank you very much.
Thank